اوكي ليرنينج اوبجكتس بتاعتنا النهارده ان احنا يعني ايه بون جرافس وبون جراف سبستيتوتس هاو تو بروموت هيلينج اوف بون وات از ذا جرافت فانكشن وات از ذا انديكيشنز تو بيرفورم بون جرافتنج سيرجريز وات ذا تايبس اوف جرافتس اند وات از ذا مينينج اوف بون سبستيتوتس فيرست تو بروموت بون هيلينج ذيز First, we have to have mechanical environment, stability of fractures, the concept of relative stability as we discussed earlier. Second is vascular environment. The bone or the graft should be in vascular envelope. This vascular envelope will institute the performance of blood-borne cells, progenitor cells, which brought by blood, and used locally in the tissues to promote osteoblast formation and bone formation. Third is osteogenic cells locally in the tissues, in the muscles, fats, or systemically from the monocytes, blood-borne monocytes, polypotent stem cells to induce formation of osteoblast and bone formation. So locally, we can enhance bone healing and union by losing either local issues or systemic issues. Locally, we can do bone or marrow grafting, electric stimulation, pulsed electromagnetic waves, ultrasound, osteoinductive factors, or systemically circulating osteogenic cyclic parathyroid hormone in a pulsatile form, parathyroid, growth hormone, statins, and vitamin D. The term osteoconduction, it's scaffold of bone that allow the cells and vascular environment to introduce into this scaffold and new bone formation. The term is cleaving substitutions. The graft we put will resorb and allow the new developing cells and blood supply to introduce inside this scaffold to promote healing. This is the term osteoconduction. It's either a function of bone grafts or calcium-based ceramic grafts, bioactive glasses, collagen composite, and synthetic polymers. So this is a scheme about different types of grafts. The term autografts, it's the graft from within the patient himself. The term isograft, it's form of allograft from another body, but it's compatible with the patient. It's isotypic, phenotypically. Again, it's from another person, it's a form of allograft, but with studies, it's histocompatible. So it's the term isograft. Xenograft from animals, allografts from human, substitutes or osteoinductive agents. Under which the autograft either vascularized grafts or non-vascularized grafts, the allografts either non-structured or structured. We'll discuss these topics one by one. So the function of grafts, it's osteoconduction, scaffold, osteoinduction, it's the function of local proteins which induce chemotaxis. These bone morphogenic proteins and other growth factors induce chemotaxis from the circulating monocytes and polypotent stem cells to come into the site of bone formation and to introduce into an active osteoblast for bone formation. And osteogenic cells, pluripotent stem cells. The use of grafts, it's either structural support in articular fractures with depression to prevent later on depression of the articular surface, to avoid failure of fracture or cavities like in cysts, or to improve healing of fractures in non-unions or in fusion. The indications in fracture non-union, osteotomies, reconstruction after tumor or infection, osteomyelitis after resection of bone, to full cavities after curettage in bone defects, and pseudoarthrosis and in long segment fusion. The first is autografts. It's either non-vascularized autografts, either cancellous bone with different types and sites available for cancellous, or cortical strat grafts, fibula, or ribs or tricortical iliac crests. Zanon-vascularized grafts is a gold standard now. It provides the three elements, osteoconduction, induction, and genic cells. It's histocompatible without disease transmission, without rejection, like allografts. However, it has local site morbidity and complications. The term reaming irrigation aspiration, it's a system during reaming of the like bone in the femur, with irrigation and to aspirate the content, every single reaming would provide 14 millimeter of cancellous bone. The autologous bone marrow aspirate, either from the sternum or from the iliac crest, either concentrated or without concentration, it would provide the bone morphogenic proteins and cells to induce bone healing and bone formation. The second is vascularized autografts. The advantage is it's in irradiated beds, areas with applied radiotherapy, or in infected beds, it resists infection. Patients with inadequate soft tissue coverage, lacking of proper musculocutaneous flaps, segmental loss more than 8 centimeters, or now the extension up to 12 centimeters length, in pseudoarthrosis and difficult cases for union. The different types of vascularized autografts, either epiphyseal transfer in children, which we need physeal growth, like after a section in patients, immature children in the proximal humerus. If we put in such age non-vascularized grafts, this distal segment will grow up and the proximal segment will not grow. So we need vascularized graft with physes. So we transfer the proximal fibula with its own physis based on the peroneal vessels and with microvascular anastomosis, so this graft will hypertrophy and will grow with the child. This is called the epiphyseal transfer. Second is intercalary based on the peroneal vessels, vascularized fibula, either free or pedicled to transfer the fibula with its own blood supply in ipsilateral tibia after a section of diaphyseal defects. So there is no creaming substitutions here. It's by direct bone formation and direct healing. So it less than time needed for healing, and it allow proper graft incorporation and hypertrophy. Also, advantages, it resists infection. It can be put in irradiated fields. All these are advantages of vascularized autografts. However, it's technically demanding. It needs microvascular surgery, lengthy surgery, and cases with epiphyseal transfer and vascularized fibula make risk for lateral popliteal nerve injury. The allografts, it's grafts from human bodies, but rather than the person itself. It's not present in Egypt except for demineralized bone matrix and femoral heads only. However, outside, in every country, there is bone banking for either structural or non-structural, structural for intercalary or even osteoarticular allografts with viable articular cartilage. It's a routine standard after resection or after resection of bone from infection or tumors to replace with allografts. However, it has the disadvantages of infection, delayed union, rejection, and mechanical failure. The structural, either intercalary or osteoarticular with preserved articular cartilage. The non-structural, it's just preserving the bone proteins. No cells, it's for osteoconduction and induction, but not osteogenic. It's either corticocancellous chips or morselized grafts or demineralized bone matrix. Preservation should be by freezing, freeze drying, or ethyl oxide, or electron beam irradiation. The term composite tissue allotransplantation, we should know a hint about it. It's a form of vascularized allografts. We transfer tissues from outside the person, from another human, with its own blood supply. And with microvascular anastomosis, we implant inside the patient. First trial in the front with flexor tendon apparatus with successful results. after which Hoffman and Kirshner performed in orthopedics for skeletal defects in the diaphysis of bone in the distal femur and the knee. 8 patients, early results were promising. However, later on, 50% developed rejection and failed. Graft substitutes, we need to, the meaning of substitutes, it's either to substitute bone autografts or allografts, or the meaning of extender or enhancer. These structures we could perform to enhance or extend the rule of bone grafts, either auto allografts, or it could be a substitute without auto or allografts. So every graft should allow the three functions of osteoconduction, osteoinduction, and osteogenic. However, these substitutes or this form of synthetic materials, it would provide only osteoconduction. There is no bone matrix, there is no proteins, and there is no cells. Okay. The rate of resorption of these materials, it varies according to the structure and geometry and the porosity of the structure. The calcium sulfate, it has the most rapid resorption, after which calcium phosphate, hydroxyapatite, it has a very, very slow resorption rate. Mechanical property. The strongest is calcium phosphate cement paste. It's strongest more than even cancellous bone of the body. After which cancellous bone, after which substance with mechanical property less than cancellous bone. We will discuss one by one. First, calcium phosphate cement. It's a base of calcium phosphate introduced by injection with different commercial names. This is the defect. The most common use of this is in tibial plateau fractures or articular fracture with depression to inject this paste in the defect, and it will stiffen, and it has a mechanical property superior even to cancellous bone. It allows early weight bearing and range of motion. After which ceramic hydroxyapatite, coralline form, with hydrothermally converted to hydroxyapatite, incorporated with a structure like cancellous bone. Many forms of beads and structures, pellets, ceramic tricalcium phosphate with many forms of pellets, beads, and wedges, granules. It has a delayed resorption rate, 6 or even up to 1.5 years. Calcium sulfate, it is very high rate of resorption and low, very rapid rate of resorption and dissolution with low compressive strength. It's only enhancer to enhance, it's combined with autogenous graft to enhance bone formation and healing. Many forms, pellets, kits, beads. This is case with tibial plateau fracture. And we do graft with adding calcium sulfate, and this is proper healing after 1 year. Collagen-based matrix, it's collagen enhanced, either type 1 or type 3 collagen, combined with hydroxyapatite or tricalcium phosphate. It's also a scaffold for osteoconduction only, without cells and without bone matrix or proteins. Demineralized bone matrix, it's bone allograft, with acid extraction of cells and salts, minerals. So the residue, the proteins only, and the growth factors. So it has osteoconduction and very minimal osteoinduction. Many forms of straps, gels are available, or paste. So it's mainly for osteoconduction and very minimal role for osteoinduction. After which they're combined bone morphogenic proteins. Bone morphogenic proteins, very big family of proteins which induce chemotaxis of progenitor cells and enhance differentiation of these stem cells into differentiated active osteoplast for bone formation. It's only functioned by osteoinduction with minimal role after adding of scaffold as osteoconduction and enhance local cells for osteogenic function. The most commonly used is bone morphologic protein 2 and 7 in clinical practice and gene therapy for SNOT has very minimal role in Egypt, but outside there are promising results for gene therapy for bone formation. So take home messages to how to promote bone healing by mechanical property, blood environmental factor and osteogenic factors, function of grafts and every type of grafts. The term autografts, it's a gold standard, either vascularized or non-vascularized. The graft must contain missing factors. The composite grafts are promising to composite the substitutes with autogenous bone grafts, and there is no perfect substitutes for autogenous bone. Thank you.